If you are getting EAFC25 DirectX errors, then you are at the right place. We have got some easy ways that you can use to fix this issue. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Method 1. Clear DirectX shader cache. The first thing you should do when you are getting DirectX errors while playing FC25 is clear DirectX shader cache. You can clear cache using the disk cleanup tool, and from Windows settings, here is how to do so. Using disk cleanup tool, type disk cleanup in the Windows search and select the disk cleanup app from the search results. In the disk cleanup window, check the box next to DirectX shader cache. You can uncheck other boxes if you only want to clear the DirectX shader cache. Click OK and then delete files to confirm. Using Windows settings, press Win plus I to open Windows settings. Go to System, then select Storage. Click on Temporary Files. Check the box next to DirectX shader cache. Click Remove Files to delete the cache. Method 2. Install the proper version of DirectX. Many games, including FC25, require a specific version of DirectX to run properly. If you have an outdated or incompatible version, it will cause loading issues. The latest version of DirectX ensures the game's improved performance. This is what you have to do to install DirectX. Search DirectX Runtime Download on Google and open the first result from Microsoft.com. Select the installer language you prefer and click on Download. Wait for the download to finish and then run the installer. Wait for the installation to finish. After the installation completes, restart your PC. Method 3. Install Visual C++ redistributables. Installing Visual C++ redistributable can be helpful since it includes a set of libraries that helps the game rely on and function normally. If these libraries are missing or outdated, it leads to loading screen issues. To install Visual C++ redistributable, search for Visual C++ redistributables in Google. Click on the first link of Microsoft.com. Download the recently available Visual C++ redistributables. Ensure you download for the correct architecture, like x64 for 64-bit systems and x86 for 32-bit systems. Install the downloaded file and restart your PC. Method 4. Troubleshoot the graphics drivers. The next thing you should do is troubleshoot your graphics drivers. Right-click on the Windows Search button and choose Device Manager. Go to the Display Adapter section and then expand it. Right-click on your graphics driver and select the Update Driver option. Click on the Search Automatically for Drivers option and follow the instructions provided on screen to download and install the latest driver. If updating graphics drivers doesn't work, you can reinstall them. Expand the Display Adapter section and right-click on your graphics driver. Click on the Uninstall Device option and follow the on-screen instructions to complete the process. After installation of the drivers, install them again. For the AMD graphics driver, install the Radeon app and then run it. Similarly, for NVIDIA graphics drivers, install and run the GeForce Experience. You should visit the official websites of your graphics card manufacturer to update your graphics card drivers. These websites are linked in the description below. Download the latest drivers for the graphics card installed on your computer from these websites. Follow the on-screen instructions to complete the driver installation process. Once done, restart your PC. Then rerun the app to check for any updates. If any updates are available, download and install them. Method 5. Run the game on a dedicated graphics card. If you have multiple GPUs for your system, then make sure to use the one for gaming, as this can tackle the graphics intensive tasks well. So using the dedicated GPU for gaming can avoid issues while playing FC25. There are different ways to check if you are running the dedicated graphics card depending on your operating system and the specific card you have. You can follow the method shown here. Press the Windows key plus R to open the Run utility. Type devmgmt.msc and press Enter to open Device Manager. Expand Display Adapters and you should see two adapters listed here. One for your dedicated graphics card and the other one for your integrated graphics card. The dedicated graphics card will have a longer and more specific name than the integrated one. The dedicated graphics card may also have a higher memory size listed. So make sure to run the game with a higher memory size to avoid loading or crashing issues. Method 6. Update Windows. Make sure your Windows operating system is up to date. Windows updates can help resolve issues with game performance. Also, updating Windows to the latest version ensures your computer runs with the latest security and performance enhancements. Type Check for Updates in the search menu and select the top option. Click on the Check for Updates button. If any update is available, download and install the updates. Restart your PC for that. Now launch the game and see if this could resolve the issue. Method 7. Run the game in windowed mode. You can also try running the game in windowed mode by pressing Alt plus Enter when in the Start menu. Check if this helps to resolve the issue. Method 8. Avoid overclocking and update bias. Overclocking the system can boost performance, but sometimes it can cause issues while playing games like FC25. So you can disable overclocking while playing this game. To do that, boot into your BIOS or UEFI settings. The process of booting into BIOS differs from system to system. You can also check the manufacturer's website for the exact process to boot into your BIOS. You can also take the help of the user manual to boot into your BIOS. Here are the basic steps to enter into BIOS or the UEFI settings. Open your Windows settings. Go to System. Select Recovery from the right pane. Then click on the Restart Now button next to the Advanced Startup. Once your PC restarts, select Troubleshoot, then go to Advanced Options. Then you should find the UEFI firmware settings. Once you boot into your BIOS or UEFI settings, navigate to the overclocking section and then disable it. You should close all the overclocking apps if you are running one like MSI Afterburner or similar applications. If you are using an outdated version of the BIOS, then this can also be why you are having issues while playing FC25. Each motherboard is different. So go through the manual of your motherboard to know how to update your BIOS. Follow the instructions to complete updating BIOS. After updating BIOS, you should not get the error. And there you have it. The methods to fix FC25 DirectX errors. We hope one of these methods have worked for you. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solves your problem. Thanks for watching and we will see you in the next video.